Well, hello, guys and gals. It's me, your old buddy, Mr. Moose, back with another edition of Farm and Simulator 2015. Welcome back to our Manchester farm, where today we are going to be doing a little bit of harvesting. I asked you a couple of days ago what your preference was, and most of you guys all said sugar beets. So that is what we are going to harvest today. And it's about time, honestly. They've been sitting there for 3.5 weeks, so it's something I've been wanting to do for quite a bit of time as well. So let's go ahead and get started. And to do so, we are going to have to jump into the store and do a little renting. We are not going to purchase the Homer T440. We're just going to rent it for a day. So let's go in using the rental mod, jump in here, and go ahead and rent it for $41,305. And of course, my rental mod sometimes works and sometimes it hangs up and I have to hit escape twice to get into it, which is really annoying. All right, and we'll go ahead and rent the chopper for it. Digger, chopper, header, whatever you want to call it. And then we'll go back into the store, and we got a couple more things we want to rent. Since we are doing this and we are taking advantage of the DLC, we might as well use the Terra variant as well. So we'll go ahead and rent that. And we'll get the auger wagon for the back of that as well. Yeah, it's annoying having to do this tabbing or escaping each time and have to come back in here. Now, normally when I do sugar beets, I wouldn't really have a need for the Terra variant. I would use a tractor chasing it with a tipper, and that would work just fine for me. But again, because we are using a mod, because the Homer DLC allows us to do the crab steering on it, you want something that you could come up next to it with the crab steering as well, so you can empty it. Now, it's going to be tough for me to do crab steering in today's episode because course play really doesn't work well with it, as well as neither does auto combine. Auto combine absolutely hates it. Auto combine will kick it out as soon as you press hire the worker. So if you have the new version of course play, you can use crab steering, but it's sort of a pain to deal with. And honestly, I want to be the guy driving the sugar beet harvester, not the guy chasing today. So I'm probably not going to use it. I'm going to use a variation of it. So anyways, we also are going to go ahead and buy a couple of things. I haven't repurchased the semi-trailer for the farm. I haven't purchased any of them. We had two semi-trailers and we also had a reefer trailer, and I haven't purchased any of that. So I want to use that today for this. So I'm going to go ahead and get the Wilson trailer. And for the truck to haul that, I'm going to take a stab with this Kenworth again and give it one more chance. You guys remember when we started to redo this farm, I purchased this and then my game crashed on me. I wasn't sure whether it was this or if it was the trailer. But to be honest with you, I've had pretty good luck with this Kenworth truck here, the Mr. Moose edition. And I just think I had bad luck that night. So I don't think it was anything to do with that Kenworth. And so yeah, let's tab through and we'll get over here to the store and we'll start getting everything put together so that we can go ahead and get out of here and get to farming. All right. Let's back her up here. Come on. Oh, I got the brake on. Duh! Way to go, Moosey. Alright, let's go ahead and pull up here. Jump in cab so we can see what we're doing here. And we'll line that up. And it's going to bounce around even though we're not touching it. And we'll go ahead and get that hooked up. And we'll go ahead and switch the front, fold that up. There we go, and it is ready to go. So let's get that out of the way. You know what? There's one more thing we need to do. And I know I don't really need this, but since we're doing it, we might as well go all out, right? Let's go ahead and get the Homer trailer. Go ahead and rent that as well. Let's do it legit, right? And so that we have that. And of course, it put it right next to me, so that's going to be interesting. I'm not going to be able to get to that right this second. Nope. Let's jump into this guy real quick. Get him out of the way, and we should then be able to get access to the header trailer there. All right. Spin her around a little bit here. Come on back in here. There we go. That looks good. All right, that is now ready to roll. Back it up out of the way. Looks like I'm getting a bunch of fire equipment together, you know? All right. See if we can get this set up now. I'm gonna swing around here. There we go. Oh, going back into the heads for the New Holland. Need to get those over to the field or to the farm and put away. All right, let's get this guy set on the trailer. There we go. All right. Now we should be able. Let's pull up here to the front of this and hook up to it and pull the whole thing out to the field. I'm really curious as to how many farmers in real life that run this machine, how many of them actually use the header trailer, you know? Is it something they regularly use, or is it just like they sometimes use it? I mean, do they always... Man, are you serious? Why? Get out that gate like that. There we go. Alright, let's get this guy brought up behind it. Come on, come on, come on. So much to do to try to get all these little pieces of machinery together. Let's go ahead and get that. Following that, don't run into the header. Alright, and the last thing we need to do is fire this guy up. And this was, again, this was a mod that was done for me by Al Smith, who is one of our folks who's part of our little community here. And he was nice enough to do that up for me as like a little Christmas gift, and I appreciate it. Everybody knows Moosey loves red for Alabama, so a little bit high getting underneath that trailer. Oh, come on now. Don't fight me. Come on. Well, I'm just having a day with this, aren't I? There we go. Huh. Fifth wheel's pretty far back there. All right. Swing everything around. Get this guy behind this guy. There we go. Now we can have ourselves a parade. Beacons on. Let's get out here on the road. Get to driving. Head over to our sugar beet field so we can get started harvesting today. Then we'll have a little bit of work that we've got to do before we can actually get started harvesting, because we've got to set up some course play. So don't think we're going to jump in the field and immediately start harvesting sugar beets. There's a process that has to take place. Also, you know, most of the time I have that whole, I don't know, my whole thinking is if I'm going to start a task, I'm going to finish the task, no matter how long the video is or whatever. That's not going to be the case for this, because sugar beets take an enormous amount of time to harvest. So each of the videos will probably be 45 minutes to an hour long or whatever. And, you know, we'll just break it up over several episodes to get it harvested, because there's no way we're getting this sugar beet field harvested in an hour. It's just not going to happen. It would take more like a live stream to get it done than an hour. All right. Let's bring this guy down in here. And I don't want to go all the way to the edge with this stuff. I want to keep it sort of out here in the middle a little bit. And let's get out and turn around and make sure everybody made it here. Oh yeah, there's our little parade coming in. It really does look like a couple of fire trucks coming in. Alrighty, are we in good enough? I think we are in good enough. Alright, so at this point, I'm going to drop the guy behind me. Unable to locate the nearby trail. Excuse me, that's what I wanted to do. Alright, I'm going to pull this guy up over here. And I'll go ahead and park him for now right here. And there's a reason behind that is I want somewhere to get the trailer where it's out of the way.
There we go.
All right. So the first thing we need to do is we need to record a course for this guy to go dump the sugar beets off. So we want to go ahead and move him into the position where we're going to want him to be for the offloading process. So let's just pull him up here somewhere where he's in good, keeping in mind that the Terra has to come in it'll have to come from in front of us. So let's pull it up sort of like so. That's good. Let's go ahead and start recording a course, and we'll go into course plays and record a course. I'll get rid of that for now. I put that up there so I wouldn't run into it when I did this. Make our turn. Bring this guy on out. And we will head back to the farm. And so the first part of this is just going to be us recording our course play course, so we can have this guy automatically go dump the sugar beets off over at the main farm where our sugar beets and potatoes are stored. So we'll do that. Jump here on the inside. Do the in cab view. So happy Monday, guys. Hope you guys are having a good day. That's when this is going up. I'm recording it late Sunday night, as you can tell. It's 1 o'clock in the morning when I'm recording this. But I didn't do a live stream tonight. If you guys were expecting me to jump up there and be there for Sunday for a live stream, just a lot of stuff went on Sunday, and I just wasn't in the mood to do one. It all started Saturday night after we did the live stream Saturday evening, which was absolutely wonderful. Thank you guys for coming out and being a part of it. But after that, I set up Adobe to process my Farm Sim video for Sunday. And decided that when I went to bed, I was just going to leave my computer running overnight, which I normally do. I set up Adobe to go ahead and process my videos for me at night. Something happened, though, in the process, and I don't know what it was. But got up Sunday, went to church, came home, got ready to upload the video to YouTube, and there were a lot of problems in the video. It stuttered a lot. It looked like a slideshow. The audio was messed up a lot in it, and it just didn't go right. So I ended up having to delete it and re-render the video. And even that video seemed like the audio was off just slightly in points of it. But anyways, I got that rendered, and then once I rendered it and uploaded it to YouTube, YouTube once again took its own sweet time with converting it up to full HD. And right now, I'm not going to put any more videos live for you guys to watch until they are fully up to HD, because I used to put them up as soon as they did, and I didn't realize they didn't go to HD for another hour or so. So now I wait until they're fully HD. They took it like 4 hours or so to go to fully HD. So by the time it went live, it was 5 o'clock in the afternoon, and I just thought, you know what? I'm not going to do a live stream. I'm going to just relax for the evening, play a little bit of this and that, maybe work on Grand Theft Auto and a couple of other things, and then I'll do my thing. So that's sort of where I was at. All right, we are here. Now, I know there are triggers on this where I could just pull up here and hit the triggers, but I'm going to go ahead and make sure that I get my I'm going to go ahead and make sure I get this right. So I'm going to go ahead and back this trailer up a little bit. I'm going to disconnect the trailer. Then I'm going to pull forward again. I'm going to take it off a pause so that I resume my route. And then I'm going to see if I can't pull up over here a little bit, like so, so that my trailer would straighten up. There we go. I'm going to go ahead and reverse now, which means I'm going to reverse here, and I'm just going to back up a straight line. So that I'm backing up my sugar beet trailer. Sorry, I always want to say it as some Southern belle every time I see sugar beet. Back my sugar beet trailer up. Anyways, and then switch into forward gear. And I'm going to pull forward again. Keeping in mind that the tractor is going to be way up here. Or the semi. It's going to be way up here, so I'm going to have it pull out this way. There we go. And now I'm going to go get my trailer again. And again, the reason I do that is because you need to record the path all the way back into the site, not just otherwise it won't work right. There we go. All right, so we got that. So the way this should work is we should come in here, and it should bring the truck in like so. Truck should come around like so. It should swing up here. It should drive up to this point here, and then it should back up and back the trailer into where that last orange dot is, which would be right there. Which should get it on the trigger point. It'll dump, and then afterwards it'll pull forward and come on up this way, and then we'll head on out. So I'm gonna go ahead and start back up recording, and we'll get out of here. Is all that necessary? Not really. I could have done it a different way, but I just sort of like doing it that way. Again, add to the realism of it. But then again, in the realism, that truck would pull up and there usually would be like a conveyor belt out there that it dumped into. Or I don't know. Some places would have a back end where they could dump into a barn or something, or a shed or some sort of storage that they put their roots in. I know a lot of people, they bring them up and they dump them, and they usually have a series of conveyor belts that they use to load them in back into wherever they're storing their potatoes. I guess every operation's different. Alrighty, here we go. Back over here we go. I don't know why I'm signaling, but I am. There's no traffic on the roads because we've got that turned off. I'm being a little bit careless with this route, and in all honesty, I probably shouldn't be, because I do have a little bit of concern that I might not be able to run this route fast enough to keep up with the sugar beets. But oops, hit that brake a little soon. Hopefully he can get over there and get back in a decent amount of time, and we'll be all right. We'll be all right. Good looking map with all the different colors on it from all the different fields. When they're all grown up and something's in ready to be harvested in each field, they look pretty good. So yeah, but anyways, talking about live streaming, I'll resume live streaming probably tonight. Again, this is Monday, so I'll probably do something this evening. Might do a little bit on Manchester. Alright, let's roll on into here. I need to go out to the right here. And I want to sort of line up with that orange dot down there, but I'm not going to drive all the way up to it. Now, a lot of people will tell you to drive all the way up to that dot for this particular thing, but what I like to do is just go ahead, because I make mistakes. If I leave it right here and I stop my course, when I go ahead and tell this to drive, when I tell this to start and drive up there, the computer is always going to drive this the exact same way every time, and it will always put the semi in the exact same place every time. So I usually like to give it this bit of distance here. I don't know, it's just something I've always done when I do these courses. Now, you could, I guess, take it all the way up to that little, you know, start point with a stop. But I tend to, by doing this, I know the computer is going, if I drive from here to here, I may wobble a little bit or whatever, and who knows if I'm going to line up perfect with it. I know that the computer is going to take a straight line to that dot. So that's the reason I do it this way. So I'm going to save this. This is field 12, and, we'll just call this, SB2. Bunker. Alright, and if I go ahead and set this for grain, for transport mode, and I want to set it up for sugar beets, it really doesn't matter. It's going to, you know, take the sugar beets because they're going to be loaded straight into it. And then all I got to do is tell it to drive course, and it's going to pull right on up there and get itself in place. And that's the majority of our work done. Now we're almost ready to harvest. So the next thing I need to do is, well, really right now I could go ahead and start harvesting some sugar beets. So let's go ahead and do that. Oops. All right, let's go ahead and get the trailer off of here. And I'm going to go ahead and pull forward, cut around here and grab that header off. And we'll get it off. Come on up to it. There we go. Alright, reverse out of here. There we go. So where is the middle of this field at? I'm going to say it's right around here where this trailer's at. Let's go ahead and get that front end folded down. And let's go ahead and make our turn here and address the the field. I'm going to say that's about centered. I'm going to go ahead and get my GPS turned on. And I'm going to make sure that we're lined up for 4 meters. I'm going to go ahead and start off manually. So let's go ahead and that is done. Let's unfold the back here. Wait, I'd already unfolded the back, huh? Ah, must have accidentally hit the trigger and didn't realize I did. All right, so we should be able to fire this guy up and start making our way through the field here. And once I get this thing straight, here we go. I want to go ahead and do an auto so I get the working width on this to 4 meters. I'll go ahead and do new. And we should be good to go on this. Now, I'm going to do the first line. I told you guys earlier I'm going to do sort of a hybrid on this. What I'm going to do is I'm going to do my first cut straight so that I'm traveling down the field and not smushing any of my crop. And then once I get to the other end of it and I start my way back, I'll switch into crab steer. I'll run the crab steer, and but then when the Terra Vera starts to come to unload us, then I'm going to have to straighten up and go into flex steering just so that I'm in a straight line so that the Terra Vera can come unload me. Otherwise, it's just problem after problem after problem. The guys at Course Play have done a great job of getting the DLC where it works. But there's just some of the stuff in it that doesn't work right. So you can actually now look, if you want to, you can set this unit up on Course Play, and as long as you start it off in crab steering, Course Play will run it in crab steering, and it will change it up and everything. But if you try and have the Terra Vera come dump this using Course Play, it just won't line up right, so. Or at least that's been my experience. We'll mess around with it a little bit. We'll probably have some errors and some conflicts, but we'll just see what happens. All right. So we're getting our sugar beets out of here. Excuse me, I gotta say it right. Sugar beets. All right. And I want to try to remember to pick my header up every time I make a turn, because somebody did point out to me that, you know, Moose, you really ought to be taking up that header every time you come out of the field because it'll gum up the knives underneath it. Yeah, I know, but in a real combine, in a real tractor, I wouldn't have to click two buttons to make that happen. I'd only have to hit one, and so that's the reason I really don't like it. So, all right, so double click on my controller. Oh, wait, I got to get back into the... See, this is what I hate about Farm Sim. I got to click the G button to go to the head, to raise the head, make the turn, and do that. But then if I want to do the crab steering, I gotta hit the G button again and then hit another button to make it go into crab steering, and it's all so annoying. But I do want to do this sort of legit today, so that's what we're gonna do. And I forget who told me this, but apparently, and I sort of had thought this was the reason for it, but in a real life situation, the reason for the crab steering is so that you're not putting the entire pressure of the machine in the same area the whole time, and really compacting down the soil. So that's the whole thing with it. That's the whole point behind it. And those little wheels up in the front, again, someone told me that the little wheels in the front that are retractable, they're there because the vehicle, because of how much the vehicle weighs and all that, laws in certain areas say that you have to have so many wheels for so many tons the vehicle is or whatever. And so when you're in the field, the six wheels are fine, but apparently on the highways it needs to have eight. And so that's what those little wheels are there for. That's what I was told anyways. I'd like to think that's true, but anyways, that was what I was told about this particular vehicle. Alright, so we're about to hit 50%, but because I don't have a vehicle running yet, it's not going to really matter. We'll finish up this pass and we'll start the next pass, and then I'll get the Terra variant brought over here and we'll get it rolling. I just want to get the middle of this field opened up, and then that way we can do our thing. Alright, so that's that. Raise our cutter head. See, there's just too many buttons I gotta hit to be able to make everything work smoothly. Alright, I need to go back to the body. Double click so it goes into crab mode. Come on forward a little bit. Click back on the head, drop the head, drive forward. Alright. And we're off to the races. We're getting it done. Alright, I'll complete this pass, and once I get that done, I'll jump in the Terra variant and set it up on course play, and then we should be ready for full runs. But anyways, hope you guys had a great weekend. I know I certainly did. Looking forward to a fun week. I've got lots planned for this week. We'll do a lot of farm sim. We're also going to work on the wind turbine project in Construction Simulator. We'll do some bus sim this week, some American Truck Simulator this week. I mean, that right there is enough, but I'm also going to try to get GTA running again. If I can get it up and running, we'll play some GTA as far as LSPDFR, but I'm not really sure. I downloaded a clean version of GTA 5 today or Sunday and installed it and played a little around, so my GTA is working again. Now I need to make a duplicate copy of it and start modding it for LSPDFR, and I'll see if I can get it to run. The issue is Alex has said that the mod that we use that basically cleans up the language for us isn't working with the new version. So I don't know, because I haven't messed around with it yet. If that's the case, that's not good, because I don't want to do it if it's going to be cuss the entire time, you know? So. Alright, swing around. I'll go ahead and switch into... I'm not going to switch into crab steering right now. Because I know in just a minute the Terra variant is going to come on and unload us. So let's just go ahead and stay straight here for unloading purposes. And we'll just pull in here. And I will go ahead and get the pipe out and get that ready, and we'll go ahead and change over to this guy and get him set up to do his thing. All right. So I need to record a course so this comes out of the field and goes over to the semi and does its unloading. I need to go ahead and open it up. Seems like a pretty good starting point right here. Let's get into course play. We'll start recording a course. Oops. How about we don't record that course? Let's discard that one. Start recording a course, put it in forward. All right, drive out of the field. Make our turn. Slowly make our turn. Head towards the truck. Not directly aiming straight at the truck, so that it doesn't give me the old stuck in traffic sign. And pull up here to this point right about here. And if I hit O, that should... Oh yeah, that's going to be good. So let's go ahead and put our pause in. And that will pause us here while it unloads. And then all we have to do now is drive off. And bring this guy back to sit over in the field. There we go. We run the risk of having a collision right here. I understand that, but we'll deal with that when it happens. Bring this back into the field here. Get in into a safe spot. And we'll stop it. I'll save that. F12. Terra. Save that. We're going to be in overloader mode. And we are going to be unloading the T440. So we want to select it. There we go. And then basically all we have to do is go ahead and say drive course. And it's going to go ahead and start rolling to get down here to unload us. And we're going to go ahead and wait for it. And once it gets behind us, or once it gets right here next to us, I'll start pulling forward and just slowly undoing the field. That is a slow moving vehicle though. I think it does what, 19? Come on, dude. You gotta run through the fruit. Whee! Look at me, boss. I have pathfinding on, so it shouldn't have done that. Alright. Let's go. Start slowly unloading. Or slowly creeping forward so that it can come up next to us and unload. Pipe is out. What's his problem? Come on, dude. I'm running straight line here. Come on. Do I gotta close the pipe in? Oh, really? Alright. Well, that's that then. Gotta have the pipe closed in for him. Only thing I really don't like about this whole thing is this syrup of sugar beets that pours out of this thing. I just think they could have done a better job with the animation on it so that it actually looks like individual, you know, units coming out instead of looking like you're pouring maple syrup off. Or, you know, taffy or something like that pouring out of there. Toffee. It just looks like some something that's all sticky and nasty. All right. Well, we continue on. I guess we can go into crab mode now. And we'll let that roll in crab mode now. I will say this, though. When you get to the top of a field and you come out, you got to come out of crab mode. Because you just can't turn it when it's in crab mode. You certainly can't be in crab left and make a right-hand turn. I tried that, and that didn't work well at all. Alright, so it's at the overloader point, and it looks like it's pouring syrup out. So... oh yeah, I see a steady stream of toffee coming out of it. Alright. Raise our head. There we go, make our turn here. Back up a little bit. All right. Kick that rear end out. And we're off to the races again. Now that guy's set for 50%, so every time I get 50% full, he's gonna come chase up next to me. And we'll just keep on doing our sugar beet. Need to get a screenshot for our thumbnail. What's the better screenshot? There we go. I like that. Oh, freeze frame. There we go. Check out the clipping motion and then everything being pulled in. Funnel back to the center with the augers. And then back through the back. And coming up, and I hear the Terravari. Nope, I thought I heard it. 3% before he gets called. It's a good looking machine, though, I will say that. Kudos to Giants, they did a really good job on it. But you expect that from them. My only downside with it is that they chintzed out on these two monitors. If you're gonna model the monitors in there, at least have them do something. You know, at least have them come on and do something. I mean, you made the air conditioner say it's 19 degrees Celsius, but you couldn't put something on those monitors? Alright, let's jump into course play. And stop our driver for a second so he doesn't run us over. And we're going to raise our head and I'm try to make this turn in crab mode just to see. Nah, it doesn't do it. It just doesn't. You can basically move around a little bit, but you can't make a turn with it. Yeah. All right. So double so I can get turning. There we go. Ugh, so many buttons you gotta hit just to do stuff. Alright, so let's go ahead and get back into crab mode. And then I want to switch over to the header. Come up here to the front, drop my header down. Get on my GPS line, and I'm good to go. Get to moving a little bit. In just a second, I'll let that guy come unload me. All right, we can start the driver up. Now I'm just going to show you. I'm going to leave it in crab mode, and again, Horseplay's going to freak out. It's going to get behind it and be like, I can't get around you. Your butt's too big. So, yeah. So, he'll come up behind us. And since he cannot get past me, I'm going to double click. I'm going to bring it in straight so he can get up next to me. There we go. Bring out that pipe and unload. That'll work. I didn't get it quick enough. I was going to take a screenshot of that. I thought it might be something cool. Alright, so now that we're back on there, we can go ahead and crab out. And that's really the only way I know to do it and still get it right, you know? Let him go by us, do his thing. Go ahead and straighten that up before I get to the end of the field. All right. We're getting our little ballet going here. Off we go. And that's that. So we're coming up on the 50 minute mark. We'll run a little bit more. I'm going to try to keep this video around an hour. And then we'll just come back and pick up where we left off. And that's what we'll do in the next video as well. And we remember, we got two fields we got to do. We've got this one, and then the second one's not nearly as big as this one. This one's just huge. But I sort of like this one being as big as it is, because you can set it up and let the crab mode do its thing. And you're not constantly having to change it. It was a good field to do. Man, could you imagine doing this in field one? Holy shnikes. That would be enormous. Alright. Man, it would be... How awesome would it be for Giants to actually get the telemetry to work on these side panels, so it actually worked, like that the time on there would actually reflect the time in game. I mean, there's so many little things that you would think they should be able to code into it. Because, I mean, they're already returning the time of day, so it can't query that and have that show up on that little screen. Eh. I don't know. I'm not a software designer, am I? Alright, get that head up. Get our position, lock in, Drop that header down, switch back to the body, switch back into crab mode. Start drilling. Digging, I mean. Alright, so far, let's see. The Kenworth is now 80% full on sugar beet. So as soon as we unload this round, and that load is thrown into it, it will be off to the races. I hadn't seen this thing dirty yet. It looks pretty good. A little dust on the tires and the rims. The hubs get dirty. Well, that's good. Alright, 50%. That guy is rolling. I will go ahead and stop him though, because I'm gonna get this thing pretty good and full before I let him come dump it. I should be able to go all the way to the end of the field, come back and get in front of him, and then we'll have a good full trailer. Because that thing can hold quite a bit in it. All right. All right, so go ahead and straighten up. Raise that front end up. Make her turn, get lined up here. There we go. Get locked in, get her header down, switch back to the body, and double click. Get us into crab mode. And I'm good to go. Yeah, we're getting up around 70%. So after we crest up here, we'll go ahead and let that guy come dump us. Because here's the deal, I want him to get me as empty as I can get, because the truck's going to go to the farm, and I'm curious to see if the truck can get to the farm and back before both of these are full. So let's get as much into it as I can get into it before I actually call him over. Which, if I remember right, I think that thing holds 35,000 liters. So we might as well go ahead and call it. All right, so let's go ahead and start him up. And let's go ahead and straighten this guy up. Just kind of slow up a little bit here, because I don't want to get to the end of the field. Wait, he can get on up here. There we go. There comes our chewy gooey nougat. That's really what it looks like. It looks like that nougat out of, or looks like the stuff that's in a Snickers bar. Whoa! How about pulling out there and knocking me out, buddy? Jeez, come on. Alright. Yeah, that's what it is. It's that gooey sitter out of a Snickers bar. The peanuts and caramel. Alright, head her down. Head on out. Switch into crab. And lay the pedal down. Alrighty, well, we're just about there to the top of the hour, and I really want to see what happens with the truck, but I think we'll end up seeing that in the next episode, and yeah, we'll hang around for that. That won't take but about 5 more minutes. Let's see, he's 100%, so he's gonna drive off, which left the Terra variant 50% full. So that means it can come over and unload a little bit out of me. It's got room for 15,000. No, it's got room for 12,000. A little bit more than 12,000. 17,000. So it's got room for 17,000 liters, and then this thing has got room for about another 36,000, something around there, 26,000. So we should be okay. We'll just see how far he gets. He's trucking on down there. Oh, the truck went into out of render, but the trailer didn't. That's funny. Alright, double click that. Raise up our cutting head. There we go. Head over here next to our trailer. I don't want to hit it. Get that head down. Alright. And keep on going with it. Go ahead and close that out. So yeah, our next episode we'll continue on with the sugar beets, and we'll get them done. And once they're done, then we'll head over to the field one and start harvesting it. Then again, I might work on the sugar beet harvest a little bit in a live stream. I don't know. Y'all might get tired of sugar beet harvest video after sugar beet harvest video. There are times when I miss having the camera on my gamepad. I just can't get the fluidness out of the hat switch on my joystick that I could get out of my gamepad. Alright, so the Kenworth's pulling up right now. Let's switch over to him real quick. Make sure he backs in right. The sugar beets kind of piled through the top of that cover. Alright, so now he's going to back in. See how good a backer he is. Not real good. I think I saw this guy on the multiplayer. That didn't work quite right. Didn't quite work right. I should have just brought it straight in. I got a mess now. See if I can correct this. Trailer brake. Where in the world is the trigger? There it is. Way further back than I thought it was. Yeah, pulling straight in might not have worked. Where is that trigger at? And why is this thing framing out after putting all those sugar beets in there? Seriously, where is that trigger point at? Alright, now I gotta look. It's right there, but it's not hitting it for some reason. Well, those are pretty shallow. Pulling straight through would not have hit it. You just got to back up almost straight in there. Huh. Wow. That's a mess. Interesting. I'm glad I looked at this to see what it was, because now I know I got an issue here. So I'll have to correct that. And now with all those sugar beets in there, I can't even get the trailer up in there. See if I can get it straight on, if I can get it to hit it. Wow, it must be this trailer. It's gotta be this trailer. I cannot get the trigger point. There we go. Of course, I just smushed all my, product. Oh, well, never mind. Now I know why. Duh, these are grain trailers. Hey, way to go, Moose. You're an idiot. And I'm stuck. Awesome, I'm just going backwards now. That's nice. Let's see if I can get it to go forward. Nope. Get out from underneath there. There. Well, I should have noticed that. Those are grain trailers. So the trigger point for armor is probably in the center of them, not on the back of them. How about that? Learn something new every day. Somebody is probably sitting right now going, I knew that. I knew that. You're an idiot. You're stupid. You don't know anything. I love when I get all that. The I knew that. All right. Reset that. Duh, it says grain trailer right on there. Duh! All right, so... let's look at what Moosey's got. Pretty sure the other one is a grain trailer as well. So, tippers, yeah, that's a grain trailer. So, if we get the agro liner, which is not a grain trailer, buy that. And we'll reset that to the farm. I should be in good shape now. Because I know this is a rear tipper. So this one will be fine. So reset that. Well, you know, I make mistakes. I'm not perfect. Though people think I claim to be. Okay. Why aren't we moving? Hello, truck. Truck. Truck, I'm accelerating. Why are you not moving? Hello. Reverse. Forward, reverse, forward, reverse, forward. Oh, did I? Wait. Oops, there we go. Duh. Oh my gosh. Look like an idiot right now. It's easy to watch the video, go back and go, man, you did this, you did that. It's a little different when you're recording and doing it. All right. Let's get going here. And we'll let this guy go back to the... let him go back to the field. Let's go ahead and see where my course is at so I can find the right set of little BBs. The little golden BBs here. Drive course. There we go. And he is on his way back to the field. There we go. And we can get our happy little thing going again. All right, that's going to do it for today, guys. Hope you enjoyed it. Isn't that funny? If you leave the ramp down, how it makes that nice, perfectly straight line there for the sugar beets. They don't pile up in there any at all. It's just sort of funny. But anyways, that's going to do it for today. I do thank you for watching, and I hope you enjoyed it. Even though I made a fool out of myself there at the very end. But you know, I should have paid attention to the fact that it was a grain trailer. Shows you how much I do sugar beets on this map. Alright guys, thanks a lot for watching. I will see you in tomorrow's video. Until then, stay safe, have a great day, and I'll see you soon. Bye-bye. Well, I hope you enjoyed today's video, and if you did, I hope you consider giving it a like, maybe even sharing it with your friends. It does help me out a tremendous amount and is greatly appreciated. Also, leave some comments down below. That's really the only way I can gauge if you guys are enjoying what's being put out. Be sure to subscribe to the channel if you want daily notifications. I try to do a new video each and every day. Also, if you want to stay in touch with me and find out what's going on, our social links are down in the bottom left-hand corner. Twitter is where I usually announce scheduled changes, live streams, and new video releases. Facebook's a great way to get in touch with me if you have any questions to ask. And of course, I am trying to get to 1,000 followers on Google+, which I know I'll probably be old and gray before that happens. But if you can jump over there and follow me, it would be super awesome. So if you like today's video, there's a whole lot more content on the channel. I hope you'll browse through it, find something to keep yourself entertained until the next video or live stream. Speaking of live streams, I try to do them nightly around 6 p.m. Central Standard Time. Until the next time, thanks again for watching. See you soon.